everyone. Welcome back to Fun in Tim's Garden. Check it out, the greenhouse, it's gone. Got the table out, chairs are ready. Right now I got some plants that I bought on the table. The reason for this, I'm waiting for all of mine to bloom. Gotta fluff it up a little bit. So we got all the plants in the ground and I'm just gonna go over that hopefully very quickly. Now on the raised garden, in the last episode we added some dirt, some compost. I forgot to mention the vermiculite that we put in as well. And that's to keep the soil nice and loose. And we've got that garden full. Inside that I put the big gym chilies, the New Max chilies. Got the peas, got two bean plants, not one, but two bean plants, and two extra tomatoes. So we're hoping for the best. Now I sort of overplanted, so I had to add some planters along the outer edge of the raised garden. Those are my peppers. Now for every pepper, I used a trick that my uncle taught me. This is a really good deal. You take about half a pack of matches, you dig your hole where you're gonna put your plant, put the matches in the bottom, put the plant on top, and that sulfur comes right on up and it makes them bloom. I've had pretty good success doing this the last couple of years, so I keep doing it. So that's my one tip. Also, I have one pot over here. I had some extra peppers, pot in the corner. I've got a New Max chili and a chocolate beauty pepper, so I can't wait to see if those go. In the art gardens, I put in all my tomatoes, perhaps too many for the area allowed, but we're gonna try. I put in the basil in the center, because remember, we wanna cross-pollinate. And finally, I put in my squash. Very excited about that. I always put the squash on the outer edge because it's big. It tends to grow outward and along the edge of the garden. I've had pretty good luck in last year's with this arrangement in that garden, so I'm just repeating the process. I'm a little worried because I keep putting tomatoes in the same gardens, and I have friends who say you need to rotate your tomatoes out. I get it. I have limited space, so this is what I'm doing. I refurbish my soil every year. I add a little bit of compost, a little bit more dirt. Every fall we put the leaves on the garden, we let it do its thing, mix it all up, put some vermiculite in to keep it nice and loose. One thing with the tomatoes that's really important, you'll notice how the stems have that nice fur along them. Now that fur is actually roots. So I'm digging a little deep, and when I plant them, you can see I'm going almost down to the leaves. This is all good because those roots are gonna expand out into the soil. Again, another tip from my uncle. Really totally appreciate it. So I hope it all works out. We should have really good gardens. We're gonna cross our fingers. This has been fun. Okay, finally we have our flowers. Now you can see I've got these beautiful hanging pots that I got, and if we're lucky, the flowers will be overflowing soon. I'm gonna have flowers all along the deck in pots. Some I'm gonna buy, some are from the seed. Just want it to look pretty by late June. Finally, out front, got all the snapdragons and the dahlias. So we'll see what happens. Kind of a shade sun area. Just want them to be pretty, want them to be tall. I think I even put a petunia out there. Love it if my neighbors can see it from the street. In all of these, you will notice a sort of puck-like device. I'm trying a new rabbit deer deterrent. Now we're gonna hope it works. I need to pick up some alpaca poo from a buddy of mine. He tells me the deer hate it. So when I get that, we're gonna put it all around our hostas, all around the gardens, just gonna cross our fingers. So that's it, the gardens are in. Now we just wait. I got some other stuff to go over that I'll share, multiple episodes coming up, so please, please hit that button and subscribe. And if you already have, thank you so much. I really appreciate it. And I've had so much fun doing this and sharing it with you. Have a great afternoon,